Hello students, under integral calculus we are going to discuss the topic few problems under integrals. So what are double integrals? Double integrals are represented by either by integral a to b, integral c to d, f of x dx dy, or the vice versa, it can be dy dx also. Now what is this notation on the right given form? This notation will be used for finding the area. Maybe some function is given, or may not, the function may not be given, evaluating over the region. So when a region is given, when a figure is given and you are asked to evaluate, find the area of that, you have to find its limits first and then you have to integrate. Whereas in this type of category problems, they will definitely give you the limits and from there you have to evaluate. That rule holds same for triple integrals also. So we are going to discuss few problems. So the first problem, evaluate integral over 0 to a, 0 to b, 0 to c, x, y, z, dz, dy, dx. So which means that the innermost integral belongs to dz, the middle integral belongs to dy, and the outer integral belongs to dx. And you need not to worry about the limits because all the limits are constant limits, which means a, b, c, or numbers 0, infinity, etc. So how am I going to evaluate? So I'm going to separate the integral x dx over 0 to a, y dy over the limit 0 to b, and z dz over the limit 0 to c. When I integrate x square, I'll be getting x square by 2 over the limit 0 to a. When I integrate y, I'll be getting y square by 2, 0 to b. When I integrate z, I'll be getting z square by 2 over 0 to c. So when I substitute the upper limit, I'll be getting a square by 2. And when I substitute the lower limit, it is going to be 0 divided by anything is going to be 0. Likewise, it will happen for y square and z square. Therefore, the lower limits are not existing for all the three. So only the upper limits are existing. So my final answer will be a square, b square, c square upon 8. Second problem, find the value of integral over 1 to a, 1 to b, dx dy over xy. So we consider the given integral as I, and we know that the inner integral belongs to the variable x and the outer integral belongs to the variable y. So which means integral over 1 to a dy by y, integral 1 to b dx upon x. So what is the integration of 1 by y by dy with respect to dy? I can write it as log y. So log y over 1 to a and log x over 1 to b. So when I substitute the upper limit, it is going to be log a, and the lower limit if I substitute minus log 1. So what is the value of log 1? Log 1 is 0. So your upper limit alone will be existing. Likewise, the previous problem, we conclude the problem by log a minus log b. Hence the solution. We move on to the third problem. The third problem is evaluate in over indefinite integral x square sine 2x dx. So we write the solution. So we consider the given integral as I is equal to x square sine 2x dx. So by the principle of ILATE, so when are we supposed to use ILATE process? So whenever we have combination of two different functions with different characteristics, which means I have an algebraic function and also a trigonometric function. So since we have a combination of two different functions with different characteristics, we have to apply the ILATE method. I stands for inverse, L stands for logarithmic, A stands for algebraic, T stands for trigonometric, and E stands for exponential. So algebraic comes before trigonometry in ILATE. That's why we give importance to the algebraic function, which is u is equal to x square, and the rest of terms will be taken as dv. So dv will be equal to sine 2x dx. So we are going to apply the Bernoulli formula. The Bernoulli formula is given by integral over u dv, which is equal to uv minus u dash v1 plus u double dash v2 minus etc. You should remember the alternate plus and minus signs. So now what is u? U is x square. And what is v? We don't have v. We have to find v. So when I integrate sine 2x, I'll be getting minus cos 2x upon 2. And the formula says minus and u dash. U dash, if I'm going to integrate u, I'll be getting 2x. And minus, what is v1? I'm going to integrate this v again, one time. Which means cos, when I'm integrating, I'll be getting sine 2x upon 4. The negative sign retains. And coming to the third term, I'll be writing differentiation of u double dash, which means when I differentiate 2x, I'll be getting 2 into what is v2? Integrating minus sine 2x upon 4. So when I'm going to integrate sine, I'll be getting cos minus cos. So I'll be getting cos of 2x upon 8. Already there is a minus sign. So minus of minus will become plus here. So which implies finally simplifying, I'll be multiplying all the terms which are outside the bracket. We'll be concluding minus x square cos 2x upon 2 plus 2 will get cancelled out in 4, right? So we'll be getting x sine 2x upon 2. And here it should be a plus sign cos 2x by 8. So next problem, evaluate integral over 0 to 1, 0 to 2, x of x plus y dy dx. One might ask me, should we apply Bernoulli here? What is your answer? No. Why? Because we have same type of functions, same characteristic functions, all are algebraic. So in order, it is separated, so we got to combine it. So if I'm going to multiply this x inside, I'll be ending up with x square plus xy dy dx. So the first integration happens with respect to y. So which means, if there is y, you integrate it. If there is no y, you just put a y there. So equal to integral over 0 to 1 x square y plus y square 2 into x over the limit 0 to 2. The inner integral is having the limit 0 to 2. So when I substitute the upper limit for y, I will be getting 2x square plus 4 upon 2 into x dx. When I'm simplifying, I'll be getting 2x square plus 2x dx. So this is the final integration with respect to x. When I integrate, I'll be getting 2x cube upon 3 plus 2x square by 2 over the limit 0 to 1. Suffice that it's going to be 2 by 3. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. I'll be landing with 1 here. So 2 upon 3 plus 1 will give you 5 upon 3 is your answer. And we are in the end. This is the last problem. Evaluate integral over 0 to pi by 2, 0 to sine theta, r dr d theta. Now the limits are in terms of r and theta, which is called as polar form. The Cartesian forms are given in terms of x, y, and z, whereas the polar forms are given in terms of r, theta, phi, etc. So solution. So let's consider the given integral as I. So now you know that the inner integral limits are 0 and sine theta. In fact, you should not have r in terms of the limits. So when I integrate r over dr, I will be getting r square upon 2 over the limit 0 to sine theta, and the rest is d theta yet to be evaluated. So just taking out this 1 by 2 outside the integral, 1 by 2 integral over 0 to pi by 2. So you have r square. So in place of r square, if I'm going to substitute, I'll be getting sine square d theta. So 1 by 2 integral 0 to pi by 2. So sine square theta, the formula will be 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2 dx. So we cannot evaluate squared functions or cubic functions, whichever you have passed. But whereas sine square theta can be differentiated. So in order to evaluate a square function, trigonometric function, we have to replace it by a linear formula. So then I split up these two things. So 1 upon 2, this 2 is getting combined with the outside 2, it becomes 1 by 4. And 1 minus cos 2 theta integrated over d theta, I'll be getting d theta of 1 will be getting theta. Cos theta, when I'm going to integrate, I'll be getting sine 2 theta upon 2 over the limit 0 to pi by 2. So 1 by 4 is outside. So in place of theta, if I substitute pi by 2, I'll be getting pi by 2, and if I substitute pi by 2 over here, 2 and 2 will get cancelled, so landing up with sine pi, which leads to 0. And the lower limit will also tend to 0. So my answer is pi by 2 into 1 by 4. My answer is pi by 8. So hope you understood all the problems. 5 problems we have discussed with limits and without limits. Thanks for watching. We'll continue in the next lecture.